Hi everyone, welcome back. So let's talk about another part on the object. So we create an object something like this, right? Every time we put the curly braces and do this. So how it is different from what we are doing with the help of object.create? How it is different from this particular piece, or both are the same? Which we already know that both are same. Either you write it like this, either you just call the object function, or you either use the new keyword. But how they are same, right? So if you talk about, oh, this is I'm creating an object and this is equivalent to this. So I hope you are aware about what the prototype is pointing to. If this is the hello function I'm creating. So if I do console.dir hello.prototype, it represents the object of the hello function, right? Which is having the proto, and proto, the constructor of the proto is pointing to the function object. This is the basic definition of the prototype of a function. It represents an object, right? So similarly, either you write the code something like this, empty curly braces, or you can write using object.create and pass the empty object from the object function. Right, both definitions look like same. Here also we are creating an object, here also we are creating the object, and here object.create is accepting another object, right? This is the argument it accepts the object proto and proto properties, right? This is what it looks for. So this is giving us the proto object, object.prototype. Similarly, if I create an object, another object from this hello function, how will I do that? So consider there is a constructor function. Okay, I will be creating a new object from here. One way to create an object from this function is using the new keyword. This is how I will create an object, right? Other way I can do that is just using the object.create, and I will pass the prototype of this function. This is another way of creating the object, and both are representing the same thing. Either you create the object like this, or either you create the object like this, object.create, and accepting the object, and it is giving you the new object. It also doing the same thing. It is actually creating the new object for this particular constructor function. This is how we create an object using constructor function, right? So constructor here is the name of that function. It can be anything. But what actually happens in object.create? If I ask you to write a method to implement whatever happening in object.create, can you write a vanilla code for it? Object create. And what we are going to accept in argument, we are going to accept a proto. Let's keep it simple for now. So we are accepting the proto in the function argument. Okay. We can write it in the better way. This is the function, and it is accepting proto as an argument. Now, what I will do, I will create a new function, right? And in the prototype of the function app, I will assign this proto. f.prototype, this is the function I have, and I will assign the proto which I received in the argument, and I will just return the new object of this function. So these lines of code is actually doing the same thing whatever we are doing here. So object.create is a function we created. We are creating the new function and assigning the proto to the prototype of that function. Okay, you already know the prototype of a function represents an object, right? Now we are returning the object of that function. So whatever you are passing in the proto, it will create a new object based on that. Okay, so this code can be used as a polyfill. Whenever you don't have that facility, you can use this to create a polyfill. But these are the important things. Both are equivalent. Why? Because it is accepting the object.prototype, and you already know that if you write this function object, object is already defined, so why I'm writing, so function.prototype, right? It is the proto object, which is this. So it is accepting the prototype, and in the prototype you have all these properties, and we are creating the function based on that, right? Similarly here, object.create constructor function we created, and then creating the another object. See both the things. This O equal to new constructor is equivalent to this function, right? Because it's the same. Object.create is accepting the prototype of that function and then creating an object. Okay, that's it, guys. I think we should move to the next methods of object function. We will talk about this in depth again when we are going to talk about the prototype of a function. In an object, we are just dealing with the proto. But when we talk about the functions, we will deal with the prototype, and then we will do a more hands-on on this.